professional. I took a couple minutes to relax, basically. But anyway, let's get started with this game like I was supposed to.
Dearest Hugh, dreadful luck. I feel terrible that you've been left alone all this time. The traitorous Dr. Gray tried to steal the annular spectrum, a ring I developed to allow perception and alteration of color. Some call them impossible colors. Impossible for Dr. Gray, maybe. Anyway, something went wrong. I turned a strange shade and became invisible. The ring, it fractured, scattering colored shards far and wide. I stayed at home for many weeks, watching, waiting, existing on this colored plane. I couldn't speak to you, nor interact with anything in the mono world. So I left. I left for the university where I hid away the colored tools I had created. I pray you have found what is left of the ring.
Fisherman caught a glimpse of something. Something unusual. Down past the lighthouse. I want to go in the lighthouse. Not the lighthouse. I got the color blue.
Pointed to the sky and declared it blue. It is this shared vision, this unquestioned understanding which connects us. But are you really seeing blue the same way I see it? Perhaps blue is nothing more than a shade of grey to you. Perhaps everyone in this world sees nothing but shades of grey. Don't you see, Hugh? This is why we're here.
Yeah, so, to my understanding of this game, it's basically the person took the colors, basically, if I'm understanding the game correctly. Dr. Gray took away all the colors where it was black and white, or if that's not it, the world was black and white. Oops. It's either the guy, okay, I can't remember, it's pink. The guy either took all of the colors, or the girl that's talking tried to make more colors. Is that you? Thank goodness I've been trapped for days. Let me get out of here. I keep hearing noises. It's creeping me out. glad that I saved him. Where's my tackle? I can hear the stupid thing, I just don't know what's at.
When you enter a cave expecting a waterfall, the chances are your expectations will be met. But if you discard those expectations, don't you think instead the cave will be full of surprises? I ask for you, Hugh, to abandon your expectations, to pull me back from the brink of unreality. I need you to see the world not for what it is, but for what it can be.
I don't know how to switch it back to gray. Maybe I can't right now. And I know that a lot of my live streams, I don't talk. I mean, a lot of my videos, not just live streams. Take fall damage in this game or not. Work out as well as I wanted it to. Didn't work out either. Run. That's what this place is for, their little collectible items. Good to know. But that is like actually something useful. I mean, maybe they are. Maybe whenever you collect all of them, they unlock something for you. Guy. That's why my tablet keeps going off.
Did you know, Hugh, that purple is at the very end of the visible spectrum? It's the hardest colour for our eyes to distinguish. Now, imagine a shade one step further than purple. A colour beyond what we can actually perceive. We call these impossible colours. And I fear that this is where I currently reside. If reality is rooted in our perception, and you cannot perceive me, do I even exist to you? I'm sure that I do. I mean, you're reading this letter, or at least I hope you are. I'm sorry, but existing in this strange state of impermanence does funny things to you, Hugh. It makes you question what is real.
I do that occasionally. I accidentally changed the wrong color. Oh, I switched it to the wrong color. Oh, I kept it for the right. But I didn't touch it. Is you have to figure out how to multitask. Oh crap. Shaman, the lizard guy again. I don't actually know who he is. I'm just gonna call him Shaman because he's like all robed up.
Gardens were bathed in an earthy orange light when I first met Dr. Gray. Summer had come and gone, and a cold autumnal crispness had caught me off guard. I sat on the grass, surrounded by my books and papers, when a cool breeze threatened to blow my notes across the lawn. A page escaped my reach and took flight. A man not much older than myself chased after it, catching it on his third or fourth attempt. I remember his gentle smile when he returned it. He started talking, and I was surprised that he had read my work in the university journal. He said he was a professor and that he hoped we could work together someday. It's funny, Hugh, how something so small can change so much.
I'll go this way.
Dr. Gray soon became my assigned mentor, and I can't help but feel he somehow had a hand in it. Our fires burnt brightest when we worked together. It felt like we could achieve anything. We discovered more about color than I could ever have imagined. We split light, mapped spectrums, we painted, we laughed. We worked long hours, and soon our goal became all-consuming. We were vessels. The work became more important than us, and we knew it.
The sad part is that actually sounds very accurate to people that puts all their time and effort to work. I don't have dark blue. Thank you. pretty certain that was lava. Oh. Anyway, guys, I'm going to go ahead and cut that episode right here. If you enjoyed, leave a like, comment, subscribe, share it with your friends. And I will see you guys in the next one. Later.